يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ.
إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد إخوتي في الله، فاعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، كل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد إخوتي في الله، قال أبو أيوب الأنصاري رضي الله عنه: جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال: عظني وأوجز. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم: إذا قمت إلى صلاتك فصل صلاة مودع، ولا تتكلم بكلام تعتذر منه غدا، واجمع اليأس مما في أيدي الناس. أخرجه الإمام أحمد في مسنده، والترمذي في سننه، وابن ماجه في سننه، وحسنه الألباني في السلسلة. إخوتي في الله، أبو أيوب الأنصاري رضي الله عنه، the first individual who hosted رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم in the city of Medina, is narrating an story, an incident that took place while أبو أيوب الأنصاري رضي الله عنه was there. قال: جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. A man, a named individual, a Sahabi, came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the way that the hadith, that the statement started, or the statement was started, it seems that this Sahabi radiyallahu anhu did not have enough time, and he did not desire much of the lectures of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he came to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa qal, "Idhni wa awjiz." Now this is a very unique. I mean, you're the one who came to the man sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You're the one who is in need. Yet, you're putting conditions on the nasiha that Rasulullah is about to give it to you. He said, radiyallahu anhu, advise me. أعطني موعظة نصيحة. Tell me something to do. Something that will benefit me in this dunya and akhirah. However, أوجز. Be concise. I cannot remember everything that you will say. I do not wish to hear so many words. I want you, Ya Rasulullah, to give me the nasiha, but be concise, brief. Samira, in short, I want you to tell me something. I don't know what it is, but something that is good. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him three different nasiha. Nasiha in ibadah, nasiha with the people, and a nasiha in the heart. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, idha qumta ila salatik, when you stand up for your salah, when you are about to study to perform the prayer, fasal salat muwaddi', pray as though this is your farewell prayer. Pray as though you are saying goodbye to this dunya, as though you will never have another opportunity for you to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And ya ikhwati fillah, the salah itself is very difficult, very hard. It may not seem to this, it may not seem like this to a number of Muslims. They may just stand up by the time that Iqamah is called. And may they believe that they can perform the salah and finish in 7 minutes and go back to their daily life. But in reality, the salah is so difficult. لذلك يقول الله واستعينوا بالصبر والصلاة وإنها لكبيرة. سبحان الله. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى in سورة البقرة واستعينوا بالصبر والصلاة, and ask the help of Allah through patience and salah. وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرًا. Not the patience itself, but the salah is so hard, it's so difficult. Why? Because if you want to perform the salah the way it should be performed, you and I would not be sitting here with comfort. We would be sweating. We would be concerned. Like Zain al-Abidin radiallahu anha. إِذَا سَمِعَ الْأَذَانِ احْمَرَّ وَجْهَ. When he hears the adhan, his face used to turn red. And he used to panic. And the people used to say, غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكَ. May Allah have mercy on you. مَا هِيَ إِلَّا الصَّلَاةِ. It is nothing but a salah. You're not going to meet your enemy. You're not going to go and meet Malak al-Maut. You are going to the house of Allah and you're going to perform the salah. فَيَقُولُ أَتَدْرُونَ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ مَنْ سَأَقِفُ. Do you know to whom am I going to speak to? Do you have any idea in front of whom am I going to stand? In front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With such a persistent and desire, that salah become so easy, so comfortable in the hearts of those who have khushu'. وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُ رَبِّهِمْ وَأَنَّهُمْ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. This salah, ya ikhwati fi Allah, it is so comfortable. It is so beautiful. It is so sweet for those who have khushu' in their hearts, for those who fear Allah, for those who are certain that they will meet Allah on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, and Allah will reward them for what they did. وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُ رَبِّهِمْ وَأَنَّهُمْ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. يقول يا إخوتي في الله, some of the Salaf رحمهم الله, he said, I struggled with the salah initially. And the only concern that I have today is that I am going to leave the salah and I have to make taslim. Ikhwati fillah, if you recall the incident that took place at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to illustrate that the salah is something that is sweet in the hearts of the believers, was the incident of Khubayb bin Adi radiyallahu anhu. A man, a Sahabi, a young man, that was asked to deliver the message of Rasulullah to other tribes. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that this man should be captured by the Quraysh. And as you know and remember, ya ikhwati fillah, before they kill him, he requested one thing which was unusual, unheard of. He said to the Quraysh, to the people who are about to kill him, إِذِنُوا لِي, allow me to perform two rak'ah. And he performed two beautiful rak'at. أحسن قيامه وركوعه والسجود in these two rak'ah. He perfected his stand, his ruku' and his sujood. And then he left the salah. And he turned to the people, فَقَالَ وَاللَّهِ لَوْلَا تُحْتَحْسَبُ. وَاللَّهِ, if you would not think that I am afraid of death, لَزْدَدْتُ الصَّلَاةِ, I would increase, I would prolong my two rak'ah. And then he looked at the Quraysh and he said, Ya Allah, اللهم أحصيهم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تغادر منهم أحدا. سبحان الله, a dua just before he meets his Lord. Imagine, you are standing in front of your enemy, and most of us, we may go down on our knees and we say, we may be pleading with these people to leave us and to forgive us and to let us go back to our family. But this young man, قال اللهم احصيهم عددا واقتلهم بددا, and do not leave any one of them. Any one of them. And he turned to them and he said, وَلَا وَلَسْتُ أُبَالِحِينَ أُقْتَلُ مُسْلِمًا عَلَى أَيِّ جَنْبٍ كَانَ فِي اللَّهِ ذَاتِ فِي اللَّهِ مَصْرَعٍ. He said, I do not care how I die as long as I'm dying as a Muslim. وَلَسْتُ أُبَالِحِينَ أُقْتَلُ مُسْلِمًا, I don't care as long as I'm being killed, I will be killed as a Muslim. I do not care how will I die as long as I have La ilaha illallah. And then he said again, Allahumma inna qad ballaghna risalati rasulik فبلغ رسولك عنا السلام. سبحان الله سبحان الله يا إخوتي في الله. He said, يا الله, we have conveyed the message of your messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا الله, give our salam to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Where is he? He is in the middle of the desert somewhere around Mecca. And Muhammad is in Medina. يقول, give him our salam, يا الله. And tell him what they did to us. And then the Quraysh, with no mercy, يا إخوتي في الله, they start cutting him into pieces. Alive. They skinned him alive. And while they were cutting him into pieces, one of them said, يا خبيب, أتحب أن محمدا مكانك وأنك في أهلك معاف. He said, يا خبيب, imagine the man is wetting the ground, that is watering the dirt with his own blood for the sake of Allah, and is in a lot of pain. And they ask him a question, say, would you prefer that Muhammad in your place while you are with your family and your children in comfort and ease? For subhanallah, when they told him, that as though he forgot about pain, he forgot about death. He forgot that they are cutting his meat, his flesh, piece by piece. And he said to them, Wallahi, ma uhibbu an akuna fi ahli wa waladi ma'i afiyati dunya wa na'imuha wa yusabu Muhammadin bishawk. Subhanallah. He said, Wallahi, I do not wish that I am with my family and children. Wa ma'i عافيه الدنيا ونعيمها. With it, I have the health of this dunya and the na'im of this dunya. And Muhammad is poked with a thorn. فقال أبو سفيان يقلب كفيه ما رأيت أحدا يحب أحدا كحب أصحاب محمد لمحمد. He said, I have never seen anyone loving anyone like Muhammad, a companion of Muhammad, love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I have not seen this. Subhanallah. The lesson from the story, ya ikhwati fillah, is that this man at that moment, and by the way, Allah delivered the message of this man, and Rasulullah said to Al-Miqdad ibn Amr radiyallahu anhu, Az-Zubayr ibn Awam, go and cut your brother down and bury him in the middle of the desert. And they did. But look, ya ikhwati fillah, his wish to pray was to pray two rak'ah before he meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كما في سنن ترمذي وغيره وحسنه الألباني قال رضي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا قمت إلى صلاتك فاذكر الموت. He said, when you stand up in your salah, remember death. فإذا ذكر الرجل الموت في صلاته فحري أن يحسن الصلاة وصلي صلاة رجل لا يظن أنه يصلي بعدها. And he said, and pray a salah that you would think, you are certain that you will not pray any other salah after this. Therefore, ya ikhwati fillah, when you leave your house, when you leave your workplace, imagine that you are coming out of the grave and the muadhan is calling and it is said of a human voice. Imagine that you're listening to the call of Israfil, to the Malak who will call people out of their graves. And the people will be running, flying towards the sound. And remember in that Allah has given you another opportunity to come to His house. And here you come. And remember, وَاسْتَمِعْ يَوْمَ يُنَادِ الْمُنَادِ لِلْمَكَانِ الْقَرِيبِ يَوْمَ يَسْمَعُونَ الصَّيْحَةَ بِالْحَقِّ ذلك يوم الخروج. And visualize and imagine that this is you leaving your house, leaving your job, leaving your workplace, leaving your business, coming to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in your way, remember that you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And while you're sitting, listening to the khutbah, or waiting for the iqamah, imagine your situation on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. When everybody is waiting for the hisab, when everyone is sitting under the sun, when there's no shade but the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when there's no hawd but the hawd of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when there's no one else to ask help for except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, imagine that you are there and you will feel the khushu' in your heart. You will feel that you're coming to the salah. And ya ikhwati fillah, when the iqamah is called, remember when Allah would call you by your name, everybody would be sitting like you are sitting. However, today you took your zina to the masajid. Ya bani Adam, khudu zinatakum inda kulli masjid. You look decent today. You look good. Your aura is not exposed. However, that day it will be exposed. And women and men are sitting together. And then the mu'adhin or the call will be called. And you will be drafted to come to this stage. And as-saiq wa shaheed. Two angels, they will come with you. يقول عثمان بن عفان ومجاهد وقتاد وابن زيد. He said those days, though that day, two angels will come with you. You will not be willingly wants to come. But these two angels, يقول, one is سائق. Meaningly, it will order you to come to Malak al-Dayyan. To come and meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second, Shahid, will testify against you. So you are walking to Allah. Can you see this? Can you see in your mind? And dressed with two angels on your side. You walking to Allah. And you don't know what you did. You don't know whether Allah would expose your ma'asi on the stage. You don't know whether Allah would cover you with His kanaf. You don't know. But when the iqamah is called, this is how you should approach the iqamah. And then remember in that walk that Rasulullah said in Sahih Muslim, إن الله لا ينظر إلى صوركم ولا إلى ألوانكم ولكن ينظر إلى أعمالكم وقلوبكم وأعمالكم. Allah will not be concerned about how you look and what the color of your skin is. But Allah will look into your heart. فمن وجد خيرا فليحمد الله ومن وجد غير ذلك فلا يلومن إلا نفسه. أقول ما تسمع واستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: ولا تتكلم بكلام تعتذر منه غدا. And do not speak of something that you will apologize about it tomorrow. It means take control of your tongue. Why, when you say something, you don't know how the other person will receive it. لذلك يقول الله If you have to say something good. يقول وقل لعبادي يقول التي هي أحسن إن الشيطان ينزغ بينهم إن الشيطان كان للإنسان عدوا مبينا يا محمد tell my servants that when they say something let them say something that is good يقول التي هي أحسن if you have to say something if you have to mention something say it in the most beautiful way so you may not apologize about it later on لذلك يقول في صحيح مسلم والبخاري النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث أبي هريرة يقول من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت whoever believes in Allah on the day of judgment let him say good or be silent and he said في سنن الترمذي وابن ماجه بسند حسن يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم لا ينبغي للمؤمن أن يذل نفسه He said, it is not befitting for a mu'min to disgrace himself. Meaning, you should not put yourself in a place where you apologize about your actions. لذلك قال الشاعر إذا شئت أن تحيا سليما معافا من الأذى وحظك موفور وعرضك صين لسانك لا تذكر به عورة امرئ فكلك عورات وللناس أكسر He said, if you want to live with dignity, You want to be a dignified individual. He said, then take control of your tongue and do not mention the faults of people. Indeed, you are full of faults. You're full of faults. Don't mention anybody else. Just look into yourself. And then he قال صلى الله عليه وسلم واجمع اليأس مما في عين الناس. واجمع اليأس يا إخوتي في الله. He said, gather yourself. Be content with what Allah has given you. And this is the definition of one of the definition of taqwa. When Ali was asked, what is taqwa? قَالَ الْخَوْفُ مِنَ الْجَلِيلِ وَالْعَمَلُ بِالتَّنْزِيلِ وَالْرِضَى بِالْقَلِيلِ So you are content and you have no need what people have in their hands. يقول الحسن البصري رضي الله عنه ورحمه قَالَ لَا تَزَالُ كَرِيمًا عَلَى النَّاسِ ولا يزالون يكرمونك ما لم تتعاطى ما في أيديهم He said people will honor you and people will treat you with honor and people will love you as long as you don't ask what they have in their hands He said but the day that you request something from them they will disrespect you they will dishonor you and they will hate you and this is human nature This is human nature. وسبحان الله Allah is the opposite of that. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي فاستغفروه